down, I left my handkerchiefs. Amen. Hello, those watching this program. This is what you call a rag that dries dishes, amen. They have always said that Pastor Dennis is one of those ghetto preachers, amen. And so I just want y'all to understand that it appeared that it might just be true, amen. For those that don't understand, amen. This is a, I don't know if it's a, it's a hand towel. Okay. I thought it was a kitchen towel. See, we're confused because some people call it kitchen towel and others call it hand towel. Can somebody tell me what kind of towel this is? But anyway, amen. It's not about the towel. It's not about the clothes. It's not about the hair or how you look. It's what's on the inside. Thank you. You know, this rag kind of made my message. Amen, somebody. But therefore, there's no condemnation. Amen. To them that are in Christ Jesus. So I'm going to hold my head up, amen. And I'm going to wipe the sweat off and blow my nose, amen. And I'm going to feel proud about it, amen, somebody. Hallelujah. In fact, I'm going to wear it on my shoulder, amen. If you have your Bibles, amen. I'm going to preach a familiar, somebody say a familiar message. Somebody say, glory to God.
Glory to God.
The Most High. Amen. And the highest praise is hallelujah. I don't hear y'all. Amen. I don't hear y'all. If I don't hear me, I don't hear y'all. Amen. So y'all should be, amen, somebody. Because there should be noise that Jesus is in. You see, people should know that we are in
the house
because there should be
noise
that Jesus is
in the house.
Hello, somebody. Mark 2nd chapter, amen. Are y'all with me? And again, he entered to Capernaum after some days. And it was a noise. Hello, somebody. And let's make some noise. I want to listen. No. Come on. But I mean, let's not start praising worship again. But let's make some noise. Amen. Amen. See, the Bible said, make a joyful noise, make a loud noise with the drums and the cymbals. Amen. Clap those hands. And let Jesus know that you're in the house. I dare you to get out of your own seat and begin to just stop those feet. Hallelujah. Begin to wave your hand and tell somebody, Jesus is in the house. Amen, amen. See, now we're making some noise. Amen. Because if y'all can't hear me, amen, we're making some noise, amen. Tell somebody, we're making some noise, amen. Everybody know he's in the house. Amen. And straightway, many, they said many, somebody say many. Many were gathered together in so much that there was no room, somebody say no room, to receive them. No, not so much as about the door, and he preached the word unto them. Amen. How many know that Jesus preached the word? See, we talk about the man that came to get healed, but we didn't talk about Jesus preached the word. Amen. Somebody. They didn't say he teach the word. Hello. We always talk about Jesus wherever he went, he taught. But the Bible said he preach, amen, somebody. Must mean there was some lost folks up in there. Hello, somebody. So listen, Jesus is in
the house.
Amen. Stay with me. And amen. And they come unto him bringing one sick, but that was paralyzed, partially that was born of four. And when they could not come nigh unto him for the press, they uncovered the roof where he was, and when they had broken it up, they let down their bed within the sick of the parts they lay. When Jesus saw their faith, he said unto the sick man that was lame, amen, but had partially or crippled, son, thou sins be forgiven thee. Amen, somebody. Somebody say, your sins are forgiven today. I don't care what you're going through. You may be crippled or sick. You may walk in like you have arthritis all up your legs. Walk in like your hands got carpetoma in it. Hello, somebody. You may walk in neck all crooked, back hurting, all bent over. But I come to tell you that Jesus is in the house. And when Jesus is in the house, I want you to understand that the Spirit of God begins to show up. And when Jesus show up, I want to tell somebody that your hand that was lying begins to straighten out, and your legs begin to get straight, and we can begin to clap our hands, stop our feet, and make a little noise and say, Jesus, I don't know about you. Oh, bless his name. And Jesus is in the house. Father God, we thank you, oh Lord. We pray, God, that the Spirit of God show up and show out. Lord, we pray that everybody in here today would just let the Spirit of God move in them, amen. Move in and out, amen. That you will receive the glory. We pray that those that are sick and afflicted will get healed today. Amen, somebody. We just pray, amen. We pray for the power of God to show up, amen. We pray for your Holy Spirit, amen. We pray for the Holy Ghost, amen. Come, amen, and dwell over this building. We pray that everybody from the east, south, north, and west begin to know that Jesus is working. Somebody say, it's not about everybody else, but it's a personal relationship with me and him. I don't know about you, amen, but I know I've been sick down in my body. Seemed like I couldn't make it, but I come to say, I woke up this morning and I said, Lord, you gotta do something to help me, because it seems like I'm not gonna make it. But I thank God I have a God that can heal anything. Amen. I'm gonna preach, amen. Let me talk a little, amen. His account, Mark chapter 2, says that the word began to spread around. You see, when we begin to go and tell people that Jesus is in the house, in a particular house, it wasn't just any house, amen. People begin to show up because people are looking for a miracle today from the Lord, amen. In fact, so many people heard about Jesus, that the house was full and no one else could get in. And you know, the thing is that we need to begin to spread the word and let people know that Jesus is in the house. People will follow you because of how you walk. They will follow you because of how you live your life, how you express yourself. Amen. It will draw people to you. Amen. When you begin to go to the church house, people are going to say, I'm going to follow because I heard that Jesus is in the house. Amen. Listen, no doubt that he was preaching a message of hope in life. Amen. No doubt. He was preaching to meet the needs of the people that was present. I'm here to preach whatever your needs are today. Amen. Whatever you're going through today, somebody say, it's fixed. Someone say, it's done. Amen. How many of you believe that it's done? I come this morning to give you some hope. Amen. To let you know whatever you're going through. Someone say, it's fixed. Amen, somebody. No doubt. The word of God will mend broken hearts. How many of you got a broken heart this morning? How many of you lost so many things in your life? You're trying to put the pieces back together. It seems like you've been torn apart. Amen. It seems like no matter what, people have just let you down. Seems like there's no hope. Hello, somebody. But I come this morning to meet whatever need that you're looking for today. You're in the very right place in the presence of God. That today, whatever you're looking for, someone say, God can fix it. We serve a big God. Amen, somebody. No doubt he was reaching with the word of God for those who was downtrodden. Hello, somebody. Somebody look at somebody and say, I'm tired of being lied on. How many of you been lied on? How many of you been cheated on? How many of you been talked about? Been mistreated. Hello, somebody. How many of you been beat? Been scorned. Hello, somebody. It seems like since the day that you was born, no matter what, it seems like you always been going through the same old situation, same old problem, same old circumstances. You're in the right place today. Amen. Somebody, I heard a noise. Amen. That Jesus was in the house. Are you still with me? You may be feeling down. Hello, somebody. Somebody say, oppress. Depressed. See, when you're depressed, it brings oppression. Amen. But listen, but the house, somebody say, the house was full because the word has spread that Jesus was in the house. There was people packed around the windows. Amen. There were people pressed in and around the doors. Are you with me? There was people that filled the yard around the house. And they were all listening to the preaching of the word. Amen, somebody? They were all straining their ear to hear a word of hope and encouragement. Amen. You see, you got to strain your ears to listen because there was so much noise. They were straining their ears to try to hear what Jesus had to say. Are you still with me? They were all straining their ears, but because of the crowd, not one more person could get into the house. Are you with me? No, not one person could even get near him to touch him. Are you with me? But along came a man that was sick. How many of you sick? Amen. Come on and raise your hand. How many of you feel that you're sick and you're afflicted? How many of you been down? Amen. How many of you didn't think you was going to make it? I don't care how young you are. You can be sick in your body. I don't care how young you are. are, you can go through the same things older people go through. Listen, tell somebody, I'm in the right place today. Amen. There were people pressed around the doors. Amen. There were people that filled the yard around the house. Are you still with me? They were all straining their ears. Here comes this sick man. The Bible said that he was sick. He was paralyzed. However, sick he was. Amen. Tell somebody, no matter how paralyzed or no matter how you feel sick you are, amen, somebody, you're going to be healed before you leave here today. Amen. They had heard that Jesus was in the house, but they could not get into the house. They knew if they could just get him to Jesus, that Jesus would do something for him. Amen, somebody. Well, let me preach to you this afternoon. Amen. If you can just get to Jesus, he can and he will work a miracle in your life. Someone needs a miracle right now. Oh, bless his name. If you would just do the best that you can to get to Jesus. Just stand up out of our seats and begin to say, I'm healed. The miracle comes when you start to believe somebody that Jesus is going to heal. I dare you. I dare you to get up out of your seat and begin to give God praise. Hallelujah, somebody. I dare you to clap those hands. I dare you to start running. Hello, somebody. My God. Someone said, I gotta press in. Listen, I gotta press in. Before I get to the story, remember the woman with the issue of blood. For 12 long years, the Bible says she had a blood problem. And listen, and they said she was unclean. She wasn't supposed to be around anybody. You don't want to talk to me. And so she hid up into a corner, Brother Dan. And she said, if I can only just the hem of his garment. To be pressed in the way, and she pressed. Somebody say, I gotta press. How many of you wanna press? Someone say, press. I dare you to press. Press through your breakthrough. Press through your situation. Press through your storm. Press through your trials. Press through your tribulations. Someone say, press. Face today, amen, somebody. He will forgive you of any sins that's in your life. How could I make such a bold statement? I can make it because Jesus is in the house. Are you with me, somebody? But you must get to where Jesus is, amen, somebody. Listen, he's in the house, and you over there, and you say, I gotta get to Jesus. Hello, are you with me? And here's the man that was paralyzed. He said, if I could only get to Jesus. Four men, they was walking, and they said, listen, we're gonna stop, because when you see someone else in trouble, church, you gotta stop and help somebody. They said, we're gonna lift them up, and we're gonna take him. We're gonna take him, amen. We're gonna take him to the house of God. We're gonna take him because I heard that Jesus was in the house. I was trying to make it, but I couldn't walk. All I can do was lay in my bed. Y'all don't want to talk to me. Pushing back. Tell somebody stop going backwards. You gotta stop going backwards. Tell somebody I'm moving forward. Was right in front of us, but they said, I'm gonna go a little bit higher. I'm gonna go up to the roof. Remind me a story of a man that was flying a jet plane, and behind him there was a rat hissing behind his neck, and he realized that if he tried to hit it, he'd lose control of the plane and crash. So what did he do? Somebody say with me. He flew a little bit higher. The higher he flew, the Christian, you've been torn apart. They said we gotta tear it apart to put it back together again. Hello, somebody. Son wasn't gonna make it. Sometimes the miracle is right in front of you. If you can't see the miracle for yourself, sometimes look at somebody else, what God did for someone else.